لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters in Islam, قال الله تعالى: واتل عليهم نبأ ابني آدم بالحق إذ قربا قربانا فتقبل من أحدهما ولم يتقبل من الآخر قال لأقتلنك قال إنما يتقبل الله من المتقين. الآيات. The story of the two sons of Adam mentioned في سورة المائدة. The verses begin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is commanding Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, recite to them, to us, the true story of the two sons of Adam, when both of them offered a sacrifice to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of them, his sacrifice was accepted, and the other one, his sacrifice was rejected or returned to him. Now, out of envy for his brother, he ended up killing him. The first crime ever committed in the face of this earth, brothers and sisters in Islam, the cause for it was envy, al-hasad. Imagine one of the brothers envied his other brother because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted his ibadah to that extent. And the first sin that we know of in details, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was disobeyed with, was also because of envy. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded Iblis to bow down to Adam, what stopped Iblis from bowing down was envy. Even though Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Iblis, why should you bow down? قال, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ما منعك أن تسجد لما خلقت بيدي. What prevented you from prostrating to someone I created with my own hands? We know, brothers and sisters in Islam, that everything is created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through the kalima, kun, except for, if you compile all the ahadith, four things Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created with his own hands. ونحن نثبت اليدين لله. We affirm that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has two hands. But we don't visualize them. Nor we try to figure out how they look like. And this is how we say, Allah has two hands in a way that suits His Majesty. And we leave it at that. If shaitan gets to you to visualize it, say subhanallah. Whatever you visualized, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is above that. And leave it. لم يتعبدك الله بالكيفية. Allah did not command you to figure out how Allah looks like. But you must believe in the attributes and the names of Allah, because they were conveyed to us in the Quran and the authentic hadith. One of them is this verse. What prevented you to bow down to someone I created with my own hands? So Adam was created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, two hands. Al-Jannah, Jannatul Na'im. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it with his own hands to prepare it for the believers. The pen, al-qalam, al-qadr, the pen with which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala writes our aqdar. And the fourth is al-arsh, the throne of Allah. Four elements. Here is a creation of Allah. Allah created with his own hands. Why he didn't bow down was al-hasad. He said, I am better than him. He envied him for the status which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given to Adam alayhi as-salam. Brothers and sisters in Islam, al-hasad, envy, is a disease of the heart that can lead to action of the limbs, which sometimes, like in the story of Cain and Abel, that can lead you actually to do something physical with your own hands. Imagine a brother had the courage to kill his own brother because of that disease of the heart, because of envy. Sometimes it can lead you to have an evil eye just by looking. And that's where the connection between envy, which is in the heart, and the eye. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fi qissat Sahl ibn Hunayf, and hear that story fi Sunan Abi Dawood, usahihatul isnad, it's authentically transmitted to us. A companion, Hadith Abi Umama, a companion by the name of Sahl ibn Hunayf. He was known to have a very beautiful complex, skin. Very nice figure. So he was bathing one day. And you know, in the old days, you do not have shower rooms to bathe. So how they used to do it? He would keep his izar, his lower garment on, and he would wash and he would clean underneath like you do with someone who is dead. So while he was bathing, cleaning himself, Amir ibn Rabi'a, a companion, passed by. He looked at him and he said, what a beautiful body. He fallen unconscious immediately. Then Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was called to the scene. And then he asked, who looked at him? مَن تَشُكُّونَ فِي, who do you doubt? Given him that eye. They said, Amir ibn Rabi'a. He said, Amir ibn Rabi'a. He called upon him. And look what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, brothers and sisters in Islam. عَلَى مَا يَقْتُلُ أَحَدُكُمْ صَاحِبَهُ. Why one of you kills his companion? Even though he did not extend the hand like the son of Adam. You see, the son of Adam, his hasad, his envy led him to actually grab something to kill his brother with. He used his hand. But look, the hasad can lead just to what? The burning jealousy can lead to this. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, عَلَامَ يَقْتُلُ أَحَدُكُمْ صَاحِبَهُ. Why one of you would kill his brother? If you see something, and this is by the way something that you should correct, because a lot of Muslims, they say what? صَلِّ عَلَى النَّبِي. The salah ala nabi is beautiful. Some of them will say ما شاء الله. Some of them actually say this and that. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. This is all wrong. When you see something that you like about your brother, about him personally, or something that he owns, you should say اللهم بارك فيه. اللهم بارك له فيه. That's what you should say. صلى على النبي. يقول لك صلى على النبي يا عم. يقول لك صلى على النبي. يا سيدي الصلاة على النبي is beautiful. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي. يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا على. It's beautiful. There is nothing wrong with that. But when you see something, you, and by the way, brothers and sisters in Islam, I want to tell you something. A lot of us sometimes may not intend to inflict harm upon that person, but just excessive fascination or excessive admiration of the person or what he has can mobilize the evil forces, which the jinn, to inflict harm upon that person, and you may not mean it. ولذلك, one of the cures, Amr ibn Rabi'ah did not mean this. He just admired his body. And he expressed that admiration. But it ended up inflicting harm upon him. Meanwhile, he should have said what? Allahumma barik fi jismi. Oh Allah, bless his body. Oh Allah, bless his car. If you see a father walking with his son, when you touch that son, say Allahumma barik fi. Because excessive admiration could lead to this, and meanwhile your intention is not that. Now just to show you the honesty of this companion, Amir ibn Rabi'ah, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, and this is one of the cures for evil eye, come, and he had him bathe, or make wudu, one of the wording. And with the water with which he made wudu, they washed Sahil ibn Hunayf, radiallahu anhum jami'ah. He stood up healthy. So one of the ways, but this after the affliction. ولذلك, يعني, some of the Muslims may get offended. يعني, sometimes you may go to a brother, listen, can I get your wudu water, please? The remains of your wudu water. Oh, why? You think I envied you? No, you shouldn't. Actually, if you're asked, yeah, go ahead, no problem. Maybe I have done it while I'm not paying attention to. Now, out of honesty, because quite frankly, envy is one of the sins. Yes, it's in the heart, but the person will be held accountable in the day of judgment if he inflicts harm upon the other people. Even though he did not physically touch anybody, but he ended up what? Looking with excessive admiration or fascination of the person. You should actually, if you feel like you have envied somebody, you should actually volunteer and give him your wudu water. Hopefully that if the person is inflected and you see that he's ill and so forth. But brothers and sisters in Islam, before I carry on with this subject in the time that I have, because unfortunately this subject became a paranoia for a lot of Muslims. Unfortunately, everything that inflicts a Muslim now, they go like evil eye. They go like hasad. They go like jinn, till this, till the. La, not every single thing that inflicts you is due to evil eye or is due to hasad. There are some causes or reasons for this, medical reasons. ولذلك, a lot of times brothers and sisters, they call us or call any imam, Sheikh, I think I'm inflicted. The first thing that you should ask the brother, did you see a doctor? Did you seek medical remedy for this? He tells you, I exhausted all the means for medical remedy. I did the scan, I did the test, and I'm still ill. Immediately, brothers and sisters in Islam, this is a possibility. But I want to say that this is one extreme. We have another extreme in the Ummah. The progressive Muslims, the people who are into rational, into intellect, الفكر المعتزل العقلانيين, they don't believe stuff like that. They tell you, man, this is backward stuff. What is this? What is this? لا, الحسد, envy is established in the Quran and in the Sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد. What are you going to do with this verse? What? ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد. You're seeking the refuge of Allah, the help of Allah, the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the envier when he envies. والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كما في البخاري ومسلم, he says, إن, شوف التوكيد هذا, look at the form of توكيد, إن العين حق. Indeed, the evil eye is true, is a fact, is a reality. It can inflict harm upon an individual. Brothers and sisters in Islam, when we use the term hasad, we know what it means. But when it comes to the type which we would like to address today, we should give it the descriptive malicious hasad. Malicious hasad or destructive envy. Why? Because there is a constructive envy which has a certain name in Arabic called al-ghibta. Ibn al-Qayyim said hasad of four types. There are four types of hasad. Number one, that you wish the person loses the ni'mah, the bounty that Allah bestowed upon him, regardless whether it gets to you or not. And this is the worst of them all. And a person, brothers and sisters in Islam, who allows his heart to carry on to reach that level, that heart is normally very filthy. Because listen, each one of us has envy, has jealousy. Allah created us in a way that you want to be like that. It's natural. But you let this go unchecked to the extent that you want the person to lose what he has without you getting it. That means your heart is so corrupt. The heart is so corrupt. And this is the worst of them all. Listen, at one stage, I want to make a disclaimer here. Not, there is no such a person who is totally clear from jealousy or envy. We all sometimes get hit by that feeling that I want to be. I wish I can. But right away, you should check yourself. This is haram. Right away, you control. It's like the desire for women. You look, astaghfirullah, let me get married. The desire for money, like anything else, that you check yourself. So this is the first time that a person would want that person to lose what he has. Man, he has a lot of money. You just wish that person loses the money. And they call this burning jealousy, that you're burning. And I'm going to come to this in a minute, that normally the person who suffers most from envy is the envier. Is the envier, because he burns inside him. Well, like one of the things that you should really treat an envier with is be patient. Because he's burning himself. He's burning himself. The second type, look at this, that you want him to lose what he has and it gets to you. So you want to be him, whether him personally, his knowledge, his position. The third type, if you become equal to him, that will help you. If he is rich, you become rich, that will suffice you. But if you do not become rich, then you retreat to one and two. You want him to lose it. You just want to be equal to him. Here is the one which is praiseworthy. It's called الغبطة. وورد هذا في حديث عبد الله بن مسعود في صحيح الإمام البخاري ومسلم. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, لا حسد إلا في اثنتين. There is no constructive, even though the word hasad is used, but constructive. There is no constructive envy except in two conditions. One, رجل آتاه الله علما, وفي لفظ حكمة وفي لفظ القرآن. ثلاثة, someone Allah given knowledge, علم, قرآن, or حكمة, wisdom. And he goes around the people and he helps them out because of his knowledge, because of his Quran, because of his wisdom. There is nothing wrong with wishing to be like this person. We should actually ask our children, I'd like to be like Imam al-Bukhari. Say, I want to be like al-Bukhari, even though al-Bukhari is dead. But I'd like to be like him. There is nothing wrong with that. That you wish to be like that person as long as you do not wish to... for him or her to lose what they have. I'd like to be knowledge, basically, Quran. Second, وَرَجُلٌ آتَاهُ اللَّهُ مَالًا, and someone Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given wealth, فَسُلِّطَ عَلَى هَلَكَتِهِ فِي الْحَقِّ. شوف التعبير. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is directing him to destroy that mal in the truth. In lawful means, like what? Sadaqah, build masajid, help that needy person. Love to be like that person. Love to be like that person. For those are the four types. Now, as if the message here, I understand that the nafs has that illness or the seed for it. Now, if you want to fulfill it in that part. Not wishing that other people would lose what they have. Brothers and sisters in Islam, before I talk about protection from envy and all of this, because quite frankly, you can't live in that sci-fi life. You're walking around, oh, he looked at me. He must give me the evil. Oh, he looked at my son. Oh, he looked at my daughter. Oh, that's... That I call it a circle of doubt. That you're going to end up doubting what? Every single person around you. La. The way is to protect yourself. ولذلك Ibn al-Qayyim, we go back to him. The eye is like an arrow. Sometimes it misses, sometimes it hits. When does it miss? When the person is protected. When the person is guarded. When does it miss? When does it hit? When you have no protection. When you have no guard on you. And the guard is al-adhkar. But let me talk a little bit about the envier. You know the problem with the envier, ya ikhwa? What is the problem with the envier? Has to do with his iman. ولذلك في حديث في صحيح ابن حبان لا يجتمع الإيمان والحسد في جوف عبد المسلم. Look at this. Iman and hasad cannot be gathered in a heart of a Muslim. impossible. What iman here? Al-Iman bil Qadr. The problem with the envier, he doesn't believe practically in al-Qadr. But listen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose this brother above me. He given me health, he given him health. He deprived me. He given him children, he deprived me. He given him wealth, he deprived me. طيب. وَرَبُّكَ يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ وَيَخْتَارُ. Your Lord creates whatever he wants and he chooses. ولذلك الحاسد سبحان الله he suffers. يعني let's go back to the story of Adam and his two children. Imagine this. Just to show you that the envier is the most stupid of all people. Your brother, Allah accepted his sadaqah, his qurbani. That means what? He is near Allah. Allah loves him. Now instead of having animosity and hate against him, why don't you love him too? And by the virtue of your love to him, Allah will give you. يعني في حديث يا إخوة عجيب, حديث أبي هريرة في البخاري ومسلم, قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, إن لله ملائكة طوافون, أو سائحين. Allah has angels who travel earth. The job of these angels is to look for gatherings in masajid where the people are studying the deen, the Quran. Immediately when one of these angels spots a masjid where there is somebody giving a lecture and Muslims sitting in front of him, that angel will call upon the other angels, come, we got one here, come. And they end up what? Circling that gathering. وذلك في الحديث, ما اجتمع قوم في بيت من بيوت الله يتلون آيات الله وكتاب الله وتدارسون فيما بينهم إلا نزلت عليهم الملائكة. الحديث يعني. A group of people in a masjid studying the book of Allah, angels would descend upon them. Then they would go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we believe Allah knows everything, يا إخوة. What did you leave them doing? Oh Allah, they are talking about you. Have they seen me? No. What would they say if they have seen me? What else? They are asking you to admit them into Jannah. Have they seen my Jannah? No. What would they say if they seen my Jannah? They are asking you to protect them from hell. Have they seen the hill? No. What would they say? At the end, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say what? They are all forgiven. غَفَرْتُ لَهُمْ. One of the angels will say what? Ya Rab! Oh Allah! One of them was not there for the lecture. You know when you have somebody, you know who you owe money? He owes money to you? Huh? And you know that he attends Sheikh Kareem classes? Huh? And you know the only way to catch him is in that class. So you come and sit right by the door. You're not really there for the lecture, but you're waiting for what? Pimsik! He was not there for the lecture. Look what Allah subhanahu, he is also forgiven. Why? هم القوم لا يشقى بهم جليسهم. They are the people that even those who hang around them, even by mistake, they will get benefit. You're getting the point, brothers. So instead of having animosity and hate against a person who's near Allah, يعني before I step out of this, يا إخوة ذكر الله كلبا في القرآن لصحبته لأتقياء. Imagine, Allah mentioned a dog in the Quran Because that dog followed who? You know what I'm talking about? The people of the cave. Imagine as they were withdrawing from the community, hiding away, fleeing the coming punishment which awaits them, a dog follows them. يذكره الله في القرآن. Why? لصحبته للأتقياء. فلا, you should love those people. The only problem that the envier have, brothers and sisters in Islam, ولذلك ورد في الأثر كل داء يرجى برؤه إلا الحسد. Every disease that inflict the heart could be cured except hasad. It's very difficult. Why? Because the person has to go back to believe in what? In qada illah wa qadari. That listen, Allah did not will this for me. Allah ordained what I have for me. Yes, I'm going to try. Even if it doesn't happen, khalas. Because really al-hasid, the envier, is asking questions that cannot be answered. Why I'm poor? Why he's rich? Can you answer that? Why is he healthy? Why I'm sick? Can you answer that? Why he has kids? Why I don't have kids? Why he's the boss and I'm not? Can you answer any of these questions? Can you answer? You can't answer any of these. You can't. You cannot. ولذلك الحسد harms most the one who envy, the one who is actually doing it. Add to this, brothers and sisters in Islam, and this is amazing, that sometimes الحسد, envy, becomes an obstacle to follow the truth. يعني يأتيك رجل كذا, a man comes to you with the truth. Just for you to grasp the essence of what I'm trying to say here, so I don't take a long time trying to convey the message to you. There was a man in Medina called Amir al-Rahib. Amir al-Rahib. Abu Amir al-Rahib. What is the story of Abu Amir? The Jews who were living in Medina circulated the news that this is the time for a messenger to emerge. Imagine the Jews in Medina, living in Medina, they knew that this is the time for a prophet from the lineage of Ismail who will come out. This is the time for it. So what Abu Amr did, he want to be that prophet. He want to be that messenger. So what did he do? He goes and he builds a sanctuary in the desert, waiting for Jibreel to come to him. He want to be that messenger. He want to be that prophet. It's like these days. You know, we have that news that there is al-Mahdi. A lot of people come and say, I'm al-Mahdi. Like this. So when the real Mahdi comes, la, it's me, not you, it's me. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was sent and he migrated to Medina, guess what? Abu Amr disbelieved. And the people would ask him, come on man, you're somebody who was promoting the principle that this is a time for a messenger, you have to do this. Come on. Says, no, I was supposed to be the guy. I was supposed to be the guy. And what was the problem of Abu Jahl, Amr ibn Hushaym and others? That the messenger came from what? Bani Hashim, not from Bani Makhzum. Again, the point, brothers and sisters in Islam, that I'm trying to convey to you, that envy can be a destructive tool, first for the envier, the person who envies. ولذلك, stay away from it. Always keep yourselves checked. If you get triggered by that jealousy towards what other people are doing, what other people are having, say Qadarullah. Remember al-Qadr. The only treatment for this disease is you go back and you believe that Allah created everything and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala distributed the proportions of everybody. When? Inna Allah kataba maqadir al-khalaiq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created, wrote the proportions, your provision of everyone 50,000 years before he created the heavens and the earth. Your name, your birthplace, your mother, your father, your rizq, your amal, it's all written. احترم قضاء الله وقدره بقى ولا ايه؟ ها؟ Respect the قدر of Allah. ها؟ Respect the قدر of Allah. This is the only treatment for the envier. Now once it comes to those who get inflected with the evil eye or with envy, one of the really things that, and unfortunately living in that community or in that society or at that age and time is especially with social media now and stuff like this, you find a brother boasting his kids on Facebook, certificate in Facebook. ايه عمي ليه ده شوف اذ قال يوسف لابيه يا ابتي اني رايت احد عشر كوكبا والشمس والقمر رايتهم لي ساجدين. يوسف said to his father, my father, I saw 11 stars, the sun and the moon prostrating to me. What was the first thing that Yaqub said to his children, said to his son? What? يا بني لا تقصص رؤياك على إخوتك. Don't tell that dream to your brothers. فيكيدوا لك كيدا إن الشيطان للإنسان عدو مبين. For the first step, don't be flashy, أخي. Don't ignite that feeling in the hearts of your brother. Especially if you know that there is a brother who doesn't have kids. Oh man, my wife is pregnant and she has twins. وهو ما عندوش اصلا, هو عقيم. And he's barren. لا ليه؟ Why? لا. والحديث يعني حقيقة الحديث ضعفه كثير ولكن الشيخ الألباني صححه. الشيخ الألباني authenticated its chain of name. استعينوا على قضاء حوائجكم بالكتمان فإن لكل نعمة حاسد. When you want to get stuff done, do it in secret. Because for every ni'mah, regardless, by the way, it could be a simple ni'mah. يعني every ni'mah, every bounty, there is someone who will envy you. For the first step is refrain. Some of you may say, طب وات يا شيخ وأما بنعمة ربك فحدث. لا, ما فيش contradictory. If you know that there is an honest brother out there who loves goodness for you, someone that you know that he loves you, he was not, go ahead and tell him. For there is no contradiction between the two commands. Yani. The second thing, brothers and sisters in Islam, al-adhkar, 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 something that we all neglected. Wallah, and we say we all neglected. And then we come, Shaykh, I have jinn, I have, what happened to al-adhkar? The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fi hadith al-Harith al-Ash'ari. Imagine this. The hadith al-Khamas, the five commands which Yahya was commanded to tell Bani Israel. Look. وَأُوصِيكُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. I command you to keep up with the remembrance of Allah. How? How? فَمَثَلُ ذَلِكَ. The likeness of this is someone who is running and behind him is a wolf. كمثل رجل خرج الذئب في ظهر تباع. Imagine you're being chased by a wolf and you're running. Now, what did he do? فدخل حصنا حصينا. Then he entered into a fortress, into a حصن. فالذكر كذلك ذكر الله. When you wake up, أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق. أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق. أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق. بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم used to bring الحسن والحسين his children. Before you bring your children out of the house, if you're afraid that there is a brother out there, أعيدكم بكلمات الله التامة من كل شيطان وهام ومن كل عين لامة. I seek refuge with Allah for your protection using the most perfect words of Allah from شيطان هامة الهوام اللي هي scorpion snakes ومن كل عين اللامة wicked eye evil eye. فالأذكار والرقى الأذكار والرقى above all brothers and sisters in Islam is keeping up with the commands of Allah, the five daily prayers. All these things were meant as means of protection for you. This is before, but after, if you know that somebody inflicted you with an evil eye, just ask him to give you the water like I mentioned at the very beginning, and there is nothing wrong with that. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. إن شاء الله tomorrow night before مغرب and عشاء I will have a whole lecture about the protection and the means, and will share more from the Sunnah, because brothers and sisters in Islam, this is a reality. But like I said before, you cannot overdo it. You cannot say everything is hasad, everything is evil eye. You cannot do this. You cannot do this. You cannot do this. And meanwhile, denying it could take you to kufr. لأنه في القرآن وفي السنة وفي أحاديث. So I'll share this with between Maghrib and Isha tomorrow. Inshallah, come and join us. Inshallah, and the means for protection. بإذن الله تعالى. يعني هذه الخطبة, this khutbah should have been about post Ramadan. Just a quick reminder, brothers and sisters in Islam. والله من أعظم علامات قبول رمضان. One of the greatest signs that your Ramadan is accepted is how are you after Ramadan, post Ramadan. Have you improved a little bit? I'm not asking you to be an angel. Listen, all of us fallen into downfall syndrome. All of us, wallahi, kulluna. All of us dropped. All of us. But now, look at this hadith. لكل عمل شرة لكل عمل شرة وفترة. Every عمل that you do has a peak and has a low. Now don't you dare allow your fatrah or fitrah to go below the commands. فمن كانت فطرته إلى سنتي فقد أفلح. Now I understand that going low is natural, but low where? That you don't pray five times anymore? Halak, destruction. That you do not engage in ibadah, that's wrong. Mandatory. فلتكن فطرتك, let be your law to the commands, to the sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. والرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم يا إخوة, يعني الصوم يا إخوة, one of the best. يعني أبو أمامة, I believe, came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, قال يا رسول الله, just tell me to do one عمل that can save me from all of this. Save me from all of this. You know what the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to أبي أمامة? عليك بالصوم فإنه لا عدل له. You cannot find a better act than fasting. Now, في حديث أبي أيوب الأنصاري رضي الله عنه, والحديث أخرجه الإمام مسلم, قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, من صام رمضان, whoever completes Ramadan. So a condition that you complete Ramadan, and this is being directed to our sisters who end up with their menstrual cycle, 7, 5, 3, 6 days during the month. First, you have to complete Ramadan. هذا وصح الأقوال. There is another opinion that you can begin with the voluntary, with the 6 days, but the most authentic, that because the hadith says من صام رمضان, whoever completes Ramadan, ثم أتبعه بست من شوال, then he would follow it with 6 days from شوال, as if he fasted the whole year. فريفايف ذا سنه. ذا مانث اوف شوال ستيل ليفت اولموست 22 23 دايز ار ليفت. It's not over yet. More than that, actually. Grab 6 days. Mondays, Thursdays. If you want to do them in sequence, you can do this, inshallah. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من شر حاسد إذا حسد يا رب العالمين. اللهم زكي أنفسنا وقلوبنا يا رب العالمين من الحسد والبغضاء يا أكرم الأكرمين.